My name is Jim Hessleman. I'm a theater performance professor here at Indiana University Southeast. We're in the middle of rehearsals for our spring show, Equus by Peter Shaffer. And with me are Drew Cash, J.R. Stuart. Drew plays Alan Strang, and J.R. plays Dr. Dysart. I chose this show. It was written in 1973, premiered in 73-74. I chose the show mainly because of concern about the internet and information these days, how much information and how quickly it can get to children, to anyone, in big lumps with no filters, no direction, and the question of who is it then that straightens out all of these images and information and guides someone to a positive, happy life. If it was that difficult back in the 70s, it must be even more difficult now for teachers, for parents, for anybody in authority, in fact, for a community to guide their citizens to a healthy life. This child is mixed up with certain images, and he acts out in a horrific way, stabbing the eyes out of six horses. And we find out through this show, Dr. Dysart finds out what is at the root of it.
Martin Dysart is middle-aged. He's very good at what he does. He is also in his own kind of a rut. It speaks to most anyone who will examine their life and find out what their passions are, where their love lies, what they worship, what they want, what they need, what they're not getting, and how much it takes to risk reaching out in love to help people. It covers a lot of issues, and it's very relevant today. We've all seen so many recent episodes of gunmen shooting people, and everyone says, well, he was a quiet boy. We thought it was a normal life he was living. Well, no, there must have been clues. So this is a way for us to risk and be aware and to help people out and realize things are going in an odd way. Well, let's correct them. Let's help them. And how far do we correct them? That's also an issue in the play. What is normal? Very relevant for a 40-year-old play.
Alan Strang, the young man who looks for his salvation in Dr. Dysart, is a fellow who spent a lot of his life in sort of an isolated state in a home without much to do, with a father who is constantly preaching about furthering his education and Marxist ideas, and a mother who is an ex-school teacher who fills his head with lots of things about religion, Christ, the Bible, and really he's not a crazy person, which I think is a temptation when you're faced with a role like this. He is a person who has developed an alternate sort of reality for himself out of this flood of information that Jim talked about before, and it's become very real for him. And through the course of that, has acted out in a way that is despicable, violent, and grotesque. And then society has to say, well, what do we do with someone like this? And like has been said, it's a very relevant question today. We see it too much, and this play has a lot to say about that dialogue, about, you know, is it just a person who should be incarcerated? Do you try to heal them? Do you let them be what they are, who they are? And I don't know if there is, in the end, I don't know that there's a real conclusion that's come to for how to deal with it. And I think with anything, every case is itself, so it has to be dealt with in that way. But as far as playing the character of Alan, I think it's important to be true to Alan's reality and not throw it away like he's just a crazy person.